My name is Sudarshan. In last class, we have seen a session related to upload process. In today's session, we are going to see the session related to the reports and dashboards part. Okay, here till now we saw how to create our database or database schema we set it up, or how the data should be flown. All those things we set it up through automation tools and through our custom object creation or different relationship between different objects. We set it up all those things, but whatever those things were related to the data I was creating, I mean how the data should be flown between different objects or how it should be created there, all those things we was set it up. But next thing is, I created a record, but how that record should be displayed to the user. Okay, or we created some information there, but how that information should be displayed to the user. Okay, whether if I need this record for my audit purpose, okay, for some in a PDF format I want it, or in an Excel sheet I want this record, then how to do this task. Okay, there is an option provided by Salesforce that is called as reports. Okay, there are different types of reports will come into picture. Okay, first report, as we are knowing, this is kind of list of records. Whatever the criteria you're going to set up, as per that you will get a information which will be displayed in rows and columns manner, and you can put a filters, groups, or different graphical chart, you can put it there. Okay, and every report can be stored in a different folders. That means in a public folder you want to set it up, or in your own candidates folder you want to set it up, you can set it up, or in a personal folder you want to set it up, you can set it up there. And those folders you can share it with the different people available in Salesforce. Okay, so as per that you can set up a security for those things, and you can set up read write access or read or create access, everything you can provide it there. Okay, in reports we have four types. Okay, tabular report, summary report, matrix report, and finally a hybrid report kind of thing, or a joint report we are going to call it as. Okay, so first tabular report. This tabular reports is like our normal table. Okay, in our Excel sheet or in our spreadsheet, how we have different columns and rows, right? In the same way we are going to have a tabular report over there. That means every column will be available. Whatever the columns you want, you can put it there, and every record whatever you are having, you will get it in a rows like that. We are going to get it up. This is just like a normal table kind of thing, we will get it up. Okay, this is very easy to set up. Tabular reports are very easy to set up, which we can create it. If you have complete business requirements, you can create a tabular report in maximum 30 minutes or something like that, max to max. It will not require that much also. Sometimes you can create it in 10-15 minutes max. Okay, like that you can create a tabular report there. Okay, then a summary report, based on some fields you are going to summarize your report there. That means you want to summarize your report based on your payment information or payment installment amount, you can do that with that. Okay, or you want to summarize with the help of some fields there, you can summarize the record over there, or you can summarize a different report there. Okay, which is similar to our normal tabular report, but only thing we are getting to, we will get is, we are going to group a record based on some fields. Okay, to get some subtotals or to get some charts. Okay, if I want to create any charts there, first we should have a summary reports. That will be a better one. Okay, generally, since compared to tabular report, this will take some time to set up here. That means we have to set up based on which field you want to based on which field you want to group these records, or you want to group a different records here there. So those things we can do it with this. And wherever we are having a warehouse concepts, there we are going to use a summary reports generally, because there we want to group a different records based on some fields, then we are going to set up like this. Okay, next is a matrix report. Matrix report is something similar to our matrix format. There we are having a rows and columns. Both rows and columns can be grouped, okay, based on some columns, so that you can create a report there. Okay, now we will see how to create these reports, then afterwards we'll go for dashboards. Okay, to create a report, first thing we should have a reports and dashboards tab. Okay, let me add those two tabs here. Let's customize a tab, my let's customize our tabs here. Let's search for reports. Let me add it here. Let's search for dashboards. Let me add it here. Let's click on save. And this tab is added only in my recruitment tab. Just click on reports. Show me later. I don't want anything else. I want to create a new report, right? So these are, if any reports are available, that will be displayed under here. Okay, these are some built-in reports provided by Salesforce when you get a org there. Okay, now I want to create my own report. Let's click on new report. Before this, if you want to create a folder here, okay, so let's create a folder. There is an option, new report folder. Just click there. We'll create a new report folder that is for candidate and payments folder. That's it. Let's save this info. That is just for a display name I'm giving. Okay, under this, okay, if you want to create any report now, just click on new report. There is no need to mention the specific report, no need to do that. Okay, no need to select a specific folder. Inside that folder only you have to create, nothing like that. You can just directly click on new report. Okay, so let's click on new report. I want to create a report for candidates and a payments, but I'm not having those fields here. These are the standard reports which is provided by Salesforce, because these are the standard fields. Okay, I mean, sorry, standard objects. Those things will automatically come into this reports folder. Okay, so I'm unable to see the other reports which I'm having here. Okay, so let's, what we'll do is we have to see that candidates report or to see my payments report, I have to enable something in my object. So let's go back to our objects, candidate and a payment information. Okay, let's go back to that objects. See, in a payment, I mean in a candidate object, there is one field called enable reports that is not enabled now. So let's enable that field, allow reports. Let's click on save. Okay, let's refresh this page. Now if I click on new report, I'll be able to get one option called other reports. This is completely for our candidate object. Okay, see, automatically when I enable the candidate object, when I enable a report for candidate object, automatically there is one thing called candidates with account. That means this candidate is related to my account. Okay, that means automatically the related object will be coming here. That means when I try to create a report for candidate, okay, that time you can select a account object also. That means related candidates account information will be displayed over there. That's it. Okay, so but I am unable to see the payment information. So to see that, again we have to go to our payment object. We have to enable that. Let's enable this, allow reports. Let's click on save. Let me refresh this again. If I click on other reports, see automatically, but here I am not seeing a payment information separately like our candidates. Since that payment information is related to my candidates, automatically which is coming up here. So to create a candidate record or to create a candidate report, just you have to select a candidate object, then you click on create. But if you want to do it with your payment information, then you have to do it with a this payment information section. Okay, so let me cancel this. Let's click on new report now. Let's click on other reports. I'm going to select a payment information there. Let's click on create. Now automatically from two objects, that is from a payment information object, from a candidate object, I'm getting two fields. That is, these two are the standard fields available in those two objects. So let's take, see, there are left side, there are so many fields are available here. Okay, left side there are so many fields are available, from a candidate field which is available, from payment information object some fields are available. See, here I am able to see owner name, alias name, role name, everything I am able to see. But in my actual field, I am unable to see all these fields available there. But there I am able to see only one field called as owner field, and created field called as created by or date, something like that. And last modified by, it was showing last modified by, with a date it was displaying. correct? So in the same way, here we are getting so many fields which will be created there. So whatever the fields you want it, just drag and drop to your report. Okay, just like this, drag and drop. Okay, just like that, drag and drop. If you want to put state, drag. Where is our country? That will be under this. Okay, I don't want to see this number field. Let me remove that. Okay, this is just like our normal tabular report. Okay, but I am able to see the summary records are repetitively coming here. Okay, that we can club it out afterwards. We'll see that. Okay, here in this is just like a tabular report. Okay, here I want to add some filterings for this. That means I don't want to see all the records which is created in Salesforce, only the records assigned to me. That means for some records I'll be the owner, only those records I want to see there, then I can make that show my candidates only. If I select all candidates, that means whatever the records are created in Salesforce, all the records will be displayed to me. Okay, and if you want to put any filtering conditions based on some date time fields, you can put those fields here, saying like all time or some last week, something like that you want to put. Yes, last week, the last week record, whatever is created automatically which is coming. Okay, like that we can set up a conditions there, but I don't want to do anything like that. I want to see all the records which is created in that. And if you want to put your own criteria or your own filters, then you can click on add here. Okay, field creator, class filter, like that. Okay, or you want to put row limit, you can put a row limit here. You want to see only 100 records, you can put it. Okay, only 99 is a maximum that one. Okay, only 99 records, click on okay. Only that field, it will display only 100 records there. Okay, if I put a different, and if I click on just add, the criteria will be created here. You can mention like when the country equals India, only those records I want to see there. Okay, let's create some record here. Let's create some info here. Okay, so like is active. I don't want to do anything like this. I'm gonna add country. Okay, I'm going to create one more record. If I, let's add one field here, account not equal to empty. These are the criteria I am going to put. If I want to remove any filter here, I can just remove this off. Okay, even though I created so many records there, but I am able to see only two records, because only the country field I am putting here, only the country record will be displayed to us. I'm just removing that. So like this, the record will be created. Okay, and here that's enough. Okay, if I want to add any payment information, I can add it there. Just going back to that, first installment I wanted to do, installment amount 2000. I don't want to do anything else. Tax also, I don't mention tax. This particular record, let's save this now. When I'm trying to save this report, it will ask me the report name. Initially I created a folder there, report folder. Now I'm going to create a report name. That means candidate with payment report. You can just click on tab here, which will ask to which folder you want to add this report. I want to add into the candidate and payments folder. Let's click on save. Now just click on run report. Like this, the reports will be displayed. Okay, since I'm an admin, I'm getting this option to customize, save, save as, like that. But if I'm a normal user, I'll get only the export details, okay, and run report. And I'll get one more thing, that is called as printable view and a subscribe. Only these things will come into picture. Let's go back to customization page. Let's try to put a payment information in records here. Okay, so here if I try to put a payment information here, see, let's put a installment, and let's put installment amount also. Okay, let's put installment amount also, and paid with the tax also. Let me go to put, and a tax field also I am going to put. Okay, like this. So these are the things I'm putting here. Now what I want to do is, see here, if I run this report. Oh, I didn't. Okay, let's go back to that. Okay, see, all those repetitive records I'm seeing right here. Okay, I don't want to see those records. I want to summarize based on my information there. I can do that with the help of a report called summary report. That is a report I'm having. Okay, I'm having a tabular report, summary report, matrix report, and a joint report. Summary report I'm selecting. On which field you want to summarize this? I want to summarize based on my candidate number. Okay, I'm just taking this candidate and I'm just dropping there. Okay, based on a candidate number I'm getting that information. Or else you want to do it based on your first name, last name, we can just put that first name and a last name over here. Okay, but if you do like this, what is gonna happen is, only based on these two fields it will come. Suppose if I have any Ganesh there, again the record will come based on a Ganesh, one more Ganesh. The KT is different, last name it will come in a different format. Okay, so like that it will come, but I don't want to do like that. In those cases we can do it with a candidate number. So let me save this. What I'm going to do is, I'm just going to add one field here, new formula field I'm going to add here. I'll just concatenate those two fields, first name and last name. Okay, the output of that is text. Let's click on next. Now I want to add two fields, that is insert field I'm doing. From a candidate I want to take a first name. Let's concatenate. Let's use one more concatenate there. In between that let's give one space. Now I want to take last name here. Click on insert. Insert. That's it. Let's try to check a syntax. Since the output of this is text, I want to make it as blank. I don't want to make it as a zero. Blank fields, I don't want to make it as zero. Let's click on next. Save. That's it. That report is done. Let's try to run this report. Let me go back to this. Let's add this now. See the candidate name which is coming there. I'm just dragging and dropping to that. Okay, earlier what was happening, first name and last name I was putting, so I was adding over there. Now I'm just removing that first name and last name. I'm just concatenating, so I'm getting only one field, so I am able to add it here. Okay, like that I can add these scenarios. Okay, so or else based on a country I want to do this, based on a state I want to do this, I can do like this. See, initially what was happening, this field, let me put it after that. See, for this guy, three records which are showing, for this guy, one record, for this guy, one record, correct? So now I want to put like this, country drag and drop into the grouping stage, state drag and drop into the group stage, that's it. In India, in state this, I'm having four records, that means two people are making a payment, okay? In the other country, I'm having one record that is making a payment over here. Like that, we can put a conditions. Let me save this. Let's see how the information will come into picture and will be flown to us, flown to the report. See, this is how the record will be displayed to the user. And if you want to export this, you can click on export details. You can export it in two formats, one is CSV format and a Excel format, or if you want it in a printable view or in a PDF format, then click on just one XLS file will be downloaded there. Okay, so like that, if you want to put any sortings here, you can put a sorting here. Okay, like if you want to put a state, you can put a state wise thing. You want to put record kind of thing, you can put it there. Okay, like that we can use a different report. Okay, let's see what is matrix report. This is just like a normal summary report, right? So if I want to put matrix report, how this is gonna display now? So first we have to do is we have to change a report type, that to matrix I have to do. Now left side which is showing the candidate, right side which is coming, I mean country which is coming here, I don't want to do like this. Let me put it here. Okay, let's take a state and let me put it here. Okay, now what is gonna happen is, for the first record I'm getting this information. For Ganesh I'm having three records, for Pavitra zero, for Robert Junior zero. Okay, like that. If you want to put any other fields, you can put it here, something like this. Okay, that three times it is gonna coming, right? So you don't want to do like that, we can do like this. Okay, like this it will display. So only observe here, I'm unable to put more than once, I mean more than two groupings here. That means only two groupings I'm able to put here. If I try to drag and drop, I'm unable to do that. I have to put into this side. Okay, then I have to put it here. I don't want to put, I mean I will not be able to put more than one record there, I mean more than one columns there. Okay, more than two columns I should be able to, I'll be able to put only three columns, I mean two columns maximum, country and a state. If I want to put this, I can drag and drop here, and you can drag and drop like this. Okay, only two fields I'm able to put in a left side, and in the same way I'm able to put two fields in a top groups. Okay, that means based on these groups I'm adding the records here. Okay, that means I'm just counting the records here. Okay, that means see, three record counts are coming. For this candidate there are three payments information are available, and this candidate is available in India, in Karnataka state. So in the same way, this particular candidate is available in France, so the count is coming for this. And for this particular person, for this which is coming, for Robert Jr., that value is coming in India and zero. Okay, like that. For France that is coming as zero. So in the same way, if I have any country records there, that means if I have a record for USA or UK, but I don't have a record for payment information for those two records, so I'm unable to see that. So let's add a payment information for other two people also. Okay, so let me refresh. Let's take this two. Let me add this payment information here. if I refresh this again, now the count will be changed. See why? Because I don't have a summary matrix report. I have to put, see the state which is coming like that. I don't want to put like this, put like this. See, for India this many things, country like this, I can put drag and drop this. See, like this I can put a information here. Okay, like that we can see the different installments here. Okay, in the same way, if you don't want to put installment here, you can put it like that. You can just drag and drop. Now it will display for one installment how many records, for two installment how many records, for three installments how many records. Instead of single count, based on our grouping, the record displaying will be changed here. And even in the show here, you, if you don't want to put details there, you want to put only the count, then you can put it there. Okay, and if you don't want to put a record count, you want to put only the information there, that is kind of a mandatory, so you'll not be able to remove that. Okay, if you don't want to put any drop zones kind of thing, then you can remove the drop zones. Okay, like that we can put a conditions, I mean we can put a groupings here, so that you will be able to fetch a different, I mean proper records there, or a proper report, effective report. See, like this we can get a information here. Based on what you want to drill down these fields, you can drill down that. Okay, like that you can create a report here. See, I created a report, but I want to add a chart now. Okay, you can add a different types of chart. Let's select one basic chart kind of thing. What should be the value in x-axis and what should be the value in y-axis? You can put different values which are available there. Okay, like this. Okay, let's take a candidate only, not additional values. That means value what you want to display, like this. Okay, I don't want to put like that. Let's click on okay. If you want to put any formatting, chart title, what should be the chart title? That is candidate payment info, like that. Okay, see, automatically the candidate info, like that one, chart style also which is coming. And here what should be the text format? You want to put any stylings for that format, you can put for all these things. Okay, so if you want to put any styles there, you can select a different style. See, like this it will come. I don't want to put a different style, but let it be. What should be the background color you want to put? You can put it there. See, like this. From color, what should be the from color, what should be the end color, like that. Okay, next, y-axis range, you want to put it as manual, you can put it, that is this side. You want to put it as a manual, you can put that. Since that is just a name, I don't want to put anything. I want to make it as automatic. Okay, you want to put any label in x-axis, y-axis, you can mention like this. Axis labels you want to mention, that is a record count name, you can select that. If you want to enable a hovering, that means when you hover on that, it will display the values there. Okay, so like that. And what should be the chart position, whether you want to display in a upper end of the report or in a below end of the report, or what is the size of that report, tiny style report or bigger report kind of thing. Okay, above report I'm selecting, just click on okay. That means before my report the chart will be displayed. If you want to edit that, you can just click on that chart. If you want to put it in below, you can put that into the below. That means first report will be displayed, then the chart will be displayed here. Okay, like that you can add a reports, I mean you can add a chart for your report. Okay, now I created a report. Next thing, I want to add a dashboard for this. Okay, this is just like our report with our information, all those things, right? But think you are just a manager, you want to see the count of the record, okay, just in a pictorial representation. You don't want to see the report, you don't want to see the different data there, you don't want to see there, you don't want to spend that much of time. Okay, in those cases you can go for a dashboard, and you can create a dashboard there. In one dashboard you can add 20 components, so that the as a manager I'll be able to see all the proper information there. I'll be able to see the information in a pictorial representation. Just this dashboard is just like a visual representation of our key metrics trends for records in our organization. Okay, and in Salesforce which will we will be able to add side by side reports there. So one dashboard will be created there. That will be considered as every reports we can consider that as one component. Like that we can add 20 components in our single page layout, in a single dashboard page layout. Okay, that means for example if I'm creating a candidate dashboard layout, there I can add 20 components related to the candidate or related to all the reports whatever I'm having in the org. Okay, so in the same way I can add a pictorial representation I was telling, right? Here we can add any type of charts there. That means I can add a bar chart, pie chart, vertical chart or horizontal chart, any donut style of chart. You can put any type of charts or a list type of chart. You can put any types of chart. Okay, and you can customize how the data should be grouped and how it should be displayed to the user and how it, the record should be summarized there. All those things you can decide it based on a report there. And mainly one thing, we will be able to create a dashboard with the help of reports and a visual first pages. That means if I have a report already, then only I'll be able to create a dashboard. If I don't have a report, then I'll not be able to create a dashboard. Okay, or at least we should have a visual first page. Okay, those visual first pages we can use. If we don't have any visual first page, then we'll not be able to create a dashboard. That means if we don't have any one of these, that means if I don't have a dashboard, I mean if I don't have a report or if you don't have a visual first page, then you'll not be able to create a dashboard. If you have a visual report, you can create a dashboard there, or if you have a visual first page, then you can create a dashboard. If you have both reports and dashboards, I mean if you have both reports and visual first pages, then you can add both to your page. Okay, to add a report, I mean to add a dashboard or to create a dashboard, just we have to go to dashboards page, but here will be redirected to the, since I don't have any dashboards there. Okay, so the dashboard page is empty, so I'm redirecting to the reports page because I have to create a report, I mean I have to create a dashboard. Now before creating a dashboard, let's create a new dashboard folder saying as dashboard folder. Just click on save. Okay, now the dashboard folder is created. Now if I go to dashboards, again same thing, it will not I'll not be able to create a dashboard there. I have to create a dashboard from a reports folder only or a reports tab only. Let's click on new dashboard button here. I don't want to see the help from them. See, there are so many different components I'll be able to add to this page, so I can add a different components here. I'm having a different components. I can drag and I can drop, but for this different components, what should be the input that I have to set up? That is a data source I'm having here. Okay, in a data source, as I was telling, the data sources can be two things. One is reports and the visual force page. If we don't have reports and dashboards, I mean reports and visual force pages, then I'll not be able to add any dashboard here. That means any components here. Okay, in a reports, since I created a new report here, that new report is displaying now. Just drag and drop that report, automatically you'll be able to see the chart here. It will come in normal horizontal chart because I just dragged and drop some components here. As per that, my page will be displayed here or my component will be displayed. I don't want to put all these things. Let me remove these things. Let's remove. Okay, I don't want to see all this chunk here. Okay, see which is coming in some style, right? But if you want to modify this, just click on that settings kind of thing or wrench button, just click on edit attributes. Okay, in a component data, in x-axis what you want to display, okay, in y-axis what you want to display. You can just put it there. So automatically how we set up a report chart, right? In the same way we can create a components, I mean we can modify the components data here. That means x-axis and y-axis we can modify here, and we can set it up here, okay. And how you want to group by this record, that means like this, okay, or based on some country you want to do, you can do that. It will take some time, 2-3 seconds max it may take sometimes. This completely depends on our internet speed, okay, like this we will be able to get. So what I'll do is I'll just make this as a candidate name, but this you may think why I'm getting only four fields here, that is candidate name, installment, country or state. You may think, right, why? Because in our reports, okay, in our report, for this particular report, candidate with payment report, what happened is, if I open this report, see, there are left side my candidate name is there, that means my page is grouped as per this, okay, that means in my groupings I am using candidate name, installment and a country and a state. So because of that only four fields which is displaying in a y-axis, okay, got it. Based on what you are grouping your report, the same fields will be displayed in our y-axis, got it. Like that we will be able to see the y-axis formats there, okay. So here in a group by also you can group by different pages here like this. This is one way, and the other thing is you want to put in a stacked format, you can select the stacked format, different stylings here basically, okay, that is completely a different styles you can use it here. The different record count, how many installments, and for green what is the name here, or for this color what should be the name, like that, which will come already, okay. If you want to display the units, whole unit, like that, you can put it here, okay. Let me put it as auto and drill down to what, source report or filtered source report or detail report. That means if you have any, when you click on this report, where it should go, okay. That means if the report is, I mean if the dashboard is opening up in my page, when I click on this report, where it should go, where I should be able to redirect, I want to see the actual information there, right? So in those cases, where I should be able to go to the filtered source report or a source report, these two are kind of same, and a records detail page. That means if I click on this record, it will redirect to my candidate information, or if I click on this payment number, automatically it will redirect to my payment record there, okay, like that. Other URL, if you have some custom URL there, you can put it there. That custom URL you will mention here, okay, like that you can do. I will redirect to my source report only, and what you want to format, okay, how the report should be displayed to you, in a descending order, in a ascending order, like that, okay, or values ascending like this, something like that, okay, or values descending, that means left side, okay. Both are similar we may think, but that is little different, okay. And maximum value is displayed, that means 100, something like that, you can put. That means this is similar to our y-axis, okay. And what should be the axis range, if I mention something here, then only the axis will come into, no, okay. Axis range is nothing but, since this is a name, I'm not getting the access in a different format directly, which is coming in automatic way, which is happening, okay. What is a legend position? That means this is our legend, where I want to show this information, okay, in a bottom or in a top, I mean bottom or a right side, only two options it will come into picture. Let me put into the bottom only. If you want to put any chatters photos there, you can put it there. Show details on hover, that means on hovering of this you want to see any information. So let me click on OK. See, the report is created. Now if I want to edit, or if I want to put any header here, you can put a header saying like okay, here what should be the title for this chart? That I can put it here, okay. And if you want to put any footer, this is like in our Word file, for one page what should be the header and footer, like that, right? You can put a headers and footers here, okay. I don't want to put that. Let's save this. Now when I'm saving this, this is same as our report saving, okay. So let me mention it as candidate payment dashboard, okay. Where you want to save this? I want to save it in my folder which is created. Just click on that, okay. Now if I want to run this dashboard, what we can do is, just open a dashboard window. From a dashboard like this will be displayed. Since I'm having only one dashboard which is showing like this, if I have multiple dashboards I can select it from this, okay. So like that, we can create a dashboard here. If you have any one more component, or if you have other components, you can add a different components here. And this whatever I am having here, right, this is dependent completely on our business requirements. See, my business requirements is saying like I have to show the pie chart here. I can show the pie chart, okay. So that means what, I was telling one more thing, right? When I click on this, where this should be redirected, which is redirected to my page report, I mean report page. So in the same way, if I want to modify this information, I can modify that, okay. What should be the display units, all those things. That is that's what I'm telling. This component data, whatever I'm seeing here, that is completely dependent on two things. One is our based on our report, the other one is based on our a type, chart type what you are selecting here, okay. Like that, if I select this, based on that the information will be changed here, like that, just like that, okay. And last two things are like some metric report, just count only it will display. Now display units, value, what should be the source report, only one, that is a total count which is displaying. Like that, when I click on this, it will redirect to my candidate record, like that, okay. Y-axis and x-axis I'll just mention like this, and I'll just mention installment amount. I want to put these conditions on this one, like that. Display units, let it be, and drill down to that. And formatting over on that, right side, something like that. If I refresh this, still I'll not be able to get the actual dashboard there. See, still it is in a horizontal report. Once I save this, that will be refreshed here, okay. And if I hover on that, it will show the proper information there. And if the other one we were seeing, no, in a formatting, drill down to what, record detail page, this one I'll put it in a bottom only. Let's click on OK, let's click on save. Initially what was happening, when I click on that, it was redirecting to my report. If I click on this now, like that, we can like that we'll be able to create reports and dashboards here with the help of Salesforce. Okay, and if I log into this page, if I don't have access to this dashboard, then I will not be able to see the information here. That means from a reports folder, okay, if I set up some access kind of thing, just one pin kind of thing, is that right? If you want to share it with any person, you can just click on that. You can add with whom you want to share the information. Just click there, you can share the particular folder with them, okay, like that. But you will not be able to share the particular particular report or a particular dashboard. You will not be able to share it with any person. You will be able to share whole folder with a different people, whomever it is required there. Suppose I want to share this report with one person, then I can click on that pin of the particular folder, then click on share. Now it will ask with whom you want to share. It will ask users. That means whatever the reports are available in that folder will be able to seen by the particular person, whoever you are setting up here. What type of access you should have? You should have editor access or a manager access, viewer access. Viewer access is nothing but he will just have a viewing, that is a read only access. If I select manager, he will be able to do both. Editor also same. Okay, so if I click on done, that's it. See, now which is showing like that. That means if I log in as that integration user, then I'll be able to see the record there. I'll be able to see the report there. If I don't want that person, I can just remove it off. That's it. Now, as that user, if I log in, then I'll not be able to see the reports folder. I'll not be able to see this particular report folder, whichever is created. Only the public folders or public reports will be displayed to every people in the org. Okay, like that we can set up a access here, or like that we can set up access for reports and dashboards. Okay, that's it for now. That's it with reports and dashboards. We are going to see the next class with complete securities, how to set up a security and how to share a record with different people. That we'll see in the next coming classes.